In the first episode of this special edition of Target Japan, we head to Sendai. The town is situated in a region struck by the 2011 earthquake and tsunami, and this is where the third United Nations World Conference for Disaster Risk Reduction was just held. Here in Sendai, Japan's Prime Minister Shinzo Abe announced a new plan for thwarting the risk of natural disasters. Over 4 years, 3.8 billion euros will be used to train 40,000 people and develop Japan's international cooperation in this sector. Several targets were set in Sendai, for example, to reduce deaths by 100,000 over 10 years, but also a reduction in the economic loss linked to natural catastrophes.
We've calculated that it's around 300 US billion per year. Particularly over the last 10 years, it's increased dramatically.
Japan has always been susceptible to typhoons. It's home to more than 100 active volcanoes, and almost 20% of all the planet's earthquakes rated magnitude 6 or more are concentrated here. Yet the number of victims is much lower than elsewhere, thanks to a real culture of risk prevention.
We have over 4,000 checkpoints scattered across the archipelago. We're able to measure the magnitude of an earthquake in an instant and immediately send the information across the country. For example, at the time of the 2011 earthquake, there were 100 Shinkansen high-speed trains in operation. We stopped them immediately and there were no accidents, no deaths.
It's the biggest infrastructure for flood prevention in the world. A gigantic main reserve tank, 5 containment silos, and a network of more than 6 kilometers of huge underground pipes. It collects water, drains flooding from 4 rivers, and spurts out up to 200 cubic meters of water per second into the region's main river near Tokyo. The impact in an area where urbanization stands at 50% is considerable.
The result is that we have 4 times fewer flooded zones, and we've cut the number of houses affected by floods by 2/3.
Standing at 634 meters, Tokyo's Skytree has become the symbol of the Japanese capital and, thanks to its structure, is earthquake-resistant. It comprises a central concrete pillar connected to external steel elements through a system of shock dampers.
The central pillar and the steel structure sway in different directions. They can offset up to 50% of the energy affecting the tower, and the tower is earthquake-resistant.
The tower also serves as a telecom system, providing data in case of natural disasters, another key element of Japan's ingenious risk prevention system.